Sorry, it's a little bit windy here now, but today we are drawing the second of a two-horse portrait that I started 2 weeks ago, and I'm going to talk a little bit about the art supplies. I'm trying new art supplies, and I'm going to talk about that, and yeah, thanks for watching. So, today I'm going to talk a little bit about the Mars Lumograph Black, which I tried for the first time in this portrait. And I have a couple of things to say about them, but first I want to talk about motivation and art block, feeling that your art isn't good enough, that your skill level isn't high enough. I've been drawing all my life, and actually until a couple of years ago, I didn't practice. I thought that if I just sat down and spent a couple of hours on a drawing, then that was what everyone was doing. And I thought that those who were very good just were so much better than me. And I thought I had to draw everything from my head. And the only time I used reference was when I was drawing someone, and I never used reference for my own material. It's so strange, it didn't occur to me at all. So I felt like I was mediocre, and I had been drawing all my life, and it felt a little bit like a childish hobby. And I thought that I couldn't do anything. And it's so strange, art, because I think that artists, no matter what kind of art they do, they just have something in them. They have this urge to make something, and no matter if you try to hide it away or do something else, it's a part of who you are. And I actually tried suppressing that part of me for many years because I thought that I had reached the peak of my abilities, even though drawing was such a big part of me and it was what I always wanted to do. And about 4 years ago, I got burned out for a lot of different reasons. And for the first couple of years, I didn't touch any art supplies, anything. I was just so tired. And the way I found my motivation again was by watching YouTube. I was laying on the couch with no energy, and I thought that if I couldn't make art, then I could try watching others making art. And I had actually never thought about that as a possibility. So that opened up a whole new world for me. And that's part of the reason I'm doing this now. And I still see people out there who are discouraged, looking at other people's work, thinking they could never be that good. And I think it's not about being the best, but if you have that urge to draw, if you have that urge to create something, then that is the end goal. And after watching others draw, I finally got the motivation to pick up a pencil. I learned that if I wanted to get better, I would have to practice, and I'm still not that good at drawing in my sketchbooks. And I also learned that with materials you use, it does matter. I always just used this regular sketching paper. I thought that was drawing paper. That was what the stores had to offer, and yeah, it didn't occur to me that that wasn't the best paper. I also learned that you should never compare yourself to others and thinking that you're not good if you're not the best. Because there are so many skilled people out there, and the only person you should compare yourself to is yourself. And that's one reason I'm going to do a 10-year challenge and redrawing a couple of portraits that I did 10 years ago. But my progress hasn't been over the past 10 years. It has been over the past 2 years, perhaps. You probably need to put in quite a few hours. It wasn't until I realized
this that I could make something that I felt good about. But after learning about the art supplies, I now have quite a lot of art supplies and I love mixed media, but lately it's been mostly portrait commissions. And the last thing I bought was the Lumograph Mars Black. And the first time I used them was in this portrait. So I have put them to the test. And as you can see in the video, I actually mostly use those. The only other pencil I use is my regular HB graphite pencil. And other than that, I use the Lumograph HB, 2B, 7B and 8B. And I had heard that they were scratchy, so I was pleased to find out that they weren't. At least I didn't think they were. They were quite soft to the paper. Felt more like my polychromos than my graphite pencils. But perhaps I have a crappy brand of graphite pencils, because that's one of the things I haven't upgraded yet. They were easy to lay down. And the 7B to 8B was quite black. When doing my blacks, I normally use my Polychromos black pencil that does have a shine to it. Sometimes I use pan pastels, but I think that's a little bit unmanageable, at least for finer details. And I also use charcoal, but I think charcoal does leave a lot of dust, so I really don't like using that, and the Lumograph was easier to get to a fine point when sharpening. Unfortunately, they did break on me quite a lot, actually, and I should have filmed the size of them now, because especially the darkest ones are quite a lot shorter. So I think this will be an expensive supply if that's the quality of these pencils. And of course I had to be careful not to put my hand in the graphite, because it would smudge. But there wasn't much dust. That's one thing I was a little bit surprised about. And they were matte, at least up until I used paper stamp on them. Then they got a shine to them. But I could just use the paper stamp to push the pigment into the paper. And then I went over it again and problem solved. They were quite good, actually. I think these will be the pencils I use for my blacks from now on. And that's about it for today. If there's anything you want me to talk about, I think because I've been drawing for so long, it's hard for me to know what people are wondering about. So I would love to get questions, then I could implement them in future videos. And there will be mostly portraits for the time being. So if there's anything you want to know about realistic portraits, just leave a question below. And yeah, and my art supplies are also listed below. And there you also have a link to my Instagram, my Facebook, if you want to follow me there. And if you're one of those who have left comments on Facebook, I just want to say thank you. Sometimes when taking on large projects, it's easy to get a bit discouraged, and posting my work in progress and getting all those great feedbacks, it's one of the things that keeps me going when I get a bit discouraged. And let me know if you want to see the 10-year challenge as well. I do have a lot of commissions now. But if you really want to see it, then I would try to find some time. So just sit back and enjoy the rest of the video, and thank you for stopping by, and I'll see you in a week.